Times Now's relentless reportage forces Mehbooba Mufti government to withdraw the order of elevation of Yasin Malik's henchman Bitta Guru.
My office was not aware of it, neither I was aware of it. Had I been aware of it, I would not have done. Very simple. Yes, we have withdrawn. On your report, immediately we have withdrawn the order. And now we'll conduct the inquiry. We'll write to the police about his antecedents and all about his, if he is involved in criminal cases, we have written to the government.
But the order has been withdrawn.
Yeah, immediately after your report.
Let me now go across to Pradeep Datta, who joins us live for more on this story. Pradeep, now this is Times Now's impact because after Times Now's relentless reportage, there has been some action.
Yes, you're absolutely right. This is a mega impact on Times Now's story because we had been reporting about how this man, Imtiaz Ahmed, who was working as a helper in the Forest Department, he was elevated by the Mehbooba Mufti government and he was made assistant manager. And this man had been the henchman of Yasin Malik. He had been spewing venom against the country, involved in several stone pelting incidents. There were terror-related cases against him. How come a person of such a credential was given such a responsible and a sensitive post? That was the issue which was highlighted by Times Now. Soon after that, there was a pressure on the government and finally they had no other option but to withdraw the order. Because this man is a complete Angoota chap. His qualification was that he was henchman of separatist leader Yasin Malik, who himself has been involved in the terror-related activity. So we question the government that how come they give that sensitive, important post? Because this was not only the issue of rehabilitation of Imtiaz Ahmed alias Bitta Guru, but this was also a case of where he was elevated to the post of assistant manager. There is every possibility that after a few years he would have been made manager and finally been inducted into the KS, Kashmir Administrative Service, or into the IAS also. So this was really a blunder committed by the Forest Minister Lal Singh. I met personally Forest Minister Lal Singh initially. He said that he was not aware of that. Maybe it was a verbal
order.
But Pradeep,
we heard what the Forest Minister had to say in this case, the Principal Chief Conservator. But the fact really is that how can he just dismiss it by saying that he or his office had no information about it?
See, that is actually the issue, because normally whenever somebody has to go for the job or they had applied for the job, the first thing that they check is the credential of that person. There is always a CID verification and the report. Here in this case, there are the visual proof that many a time this person had been seen to be involved in the activities which normally the government employee should not be. He is always seen as a right-hand man of separatist leader Yasin Malik. There had been several stone pelting incidents where he was a part of that. He had been spewing venom against the country and he had been in fact involved in several terror-related incidents also. There are cases against him. So how come a person without any department checking the credentials? When I asked this question to the Principal Chief Conservator Forest, he said that we got the report which clearly mentioned that there was no adverse record against him. So there was no other option. But the reality is that because Principal Chief Conservator has no other option, when you are getting in fact the direction from the top, and this time the direction had come from the Forest Minister, and now when Times Now highlighted
But one thing
story,
is clear, so now there's going to be no government post for Yasin Malik's henchman. Pradeep, thank you very much for joining us and getting us those details.